through those trouble spots, of course, along with temperatures, we have started our cool down, but those places that had storms coming through, you're already cooler. Look at that, Thompson at 76, and you guys in Sparta, they're going to get a lot cooler a lot faster soon as well. I'll have more details coming up in the full forecast.
Right, thanks. Coverage you can count on continues now with new developments with the Augusta Judicial Circuit.
Yeah, it's still together despite a judge ruling this week that Columbia County could break off. News Channel 6's Chloe Salsameda has the latest.
We were here Monday when a judge ruled Columbia County could split from the Augusta Judicial Circuit, but that can't happen until the Georgia Supreme Court makes a decision. Columbia County will remain in the Augusta Judicial Circuit for now.
Senate Bill 9 is out.
This week, a judge ruled that the law allowing the county to leave the circuit is valid and does not violate any laws. But the Georgia Supreme Court will have the final say. Attorney Jack Long represents Willie Saunders, who is suing Georgia Governor Brian Kemp, Richmond, Columbia, and Burke counties to keep the circuit together. Long believes it'll be a lengthy process to a final decision, as the Supreme Court will likely want to hear from all parties involved.
We all knew it would be going to the Supreme Court, but I think they will eventually say, we want to hear all this together, and they'll set it down for an oral argument.
It's still unclear when the Georgia Supreme Court can make their decision. Attorney Jack Long says it may not happen until the end of the year. In Augusta, Chloe Salsameda, WJBF News Channel 6.
It's been nearly a year since Julian Lewis.
Now you know. Get the cheese crystal you crave. Only at Crystal.
An animal shelter in South Carolina has gone to Facebook asking for the community's help.
And News Channel 6's Mary Calkins has the story.
The Aiken County Animal Shelter is at full capacity and looking for people to foster and adopt pets like these.
The shelter has taken in over 160 animals in the past 2 weeks alone. All 84 dog kennels at the shelter are full, and Thursday, 15 more dogs were brought in.
They're coming in not knowing what's going on. Why am I here? They can smell all these other animals. Then you put them in a cage with over 100 to 150 dogs, and it's just a nightmare right now.
Friends of the animal shelter went to Facebook saying, the shelter does not want to have to make hard decisions, but dogs are doubled up in the intake kennels, and we need your help. The post now has over 900 shares, and they're hoping for a major outcome.
And we're open in a few minutes, 12 o'clock, we'll be up for intake, and I know people are coming in.
It's not their fault that they're here, and we're just really trying to get them in homes as quickly as we can.
And for those not ready to adopt, Arthur says the shelter is in desperate need of foster families.
Maybe anywhere from 2 weeks, could be for 2 weeks to a month to foster, maybe a week, you know, just for that moment in time, because we're so overrun.
And he says if you're looking to adopt an animal, always check your local shelter first.
Our shelter pets are the most lovable pets. We have some great pets up for adoption right now.
For information on the Aiken County Animal Shelter, look for the story on our website. In Aiken, Mary Calkins, WJBF, News Channel 6.
Well, some leaders in Aiken County say they want to...